Hello students, welcome to this new session of Python. Today we are going to study mail merge, which is part of unit 4, regular expression. Again, as I had told you in the last session, we have small practical topics in unit 4 which we are going to cover up, and they are all practical topics. Now first of all, let us try to understand what is mail merge and from where the concept came. Ideally you should have studied mail merge in SEM 1 or SEM 2. If you are aware about the concept, it is very good, but I am going to do the revision. And then in the sense, first we are going to study mail merge using Word and Excel, that is the traditional mail merge, in order to understand the concept. And then we are going to study how we can do it making use of Python. Yes, I am going to give you some practical homework also, so pay attention during the session, try to note down the things, and you have to do the same things practically as well. So let's get started. Fine. Now first of all, what is mail merge and how the concept came? In the early days of computing, when word processors and spreadsheets came up, what happened was there was one file, as you can observe, one Excel sheet is there. Excel sheets are generally referred to as spreadsheets, where you have the data of multiple people, their name, address, city, and you have another document which is a Word document, assumed to be a letter, which you want to send to all the people or some of the people whose data is there in the spreadsheet. So again I repeat, you have two files. One is say for example a letter. Here the letter is invitation for a birthday party. It can be any kind of letter. It can be a business letter, it can be a personal letter, or anything. Basically that common text which you want to send to multiple people. Now multiple people you have in a separate file, which is a spreadsheet file, and you have their name and addresses. So we want to send a separate invitation to, say for example, here there are four names. So you want to send a separate birthday invitation to all these four people whose names are there in the spreadsheet. If more names are there, you can send it to more. If less names are there, you can send it to less. So how to do this mail merge? So first of all, as you see, we have one Word file which is docx file, and we have one spreadsheet which is xlsx file. Using these two file, we are going to create a separate invitation for each of the person, each of the celebrity that is listed over here. So what you are interested in doing is, we are taking Virat Kohli, and Virat Kohli wants to send invitation to some of his friends to attend his birthday party. So here what he wants to, the first name, the address, city, the name of the friend, and this should be changed as per the details given in this Excel file. So how can we do the mail merge? It is possible through Word file. There is an option known as mailings. Okay, there is an option known as mailings. Now you can do it making use of a wizard, but I am teaching you without the wizard, through steps one by one, which is a better option. So the first task is to select the recipients. Recipient means you want to send this invitation to some of your friends. So your friends are known as recipients. The spreadsheet basically contains the recipient list. So you want to send separate invitation to each of the recipients. So what you have to do here, you have to select the file where the data of your recipients exist. Yes, there are several options. Type a new list, that means you can create a new list of the recipients. You can use an existing list or choose from Outlook contacts. If your contacts are already existing in Outlook Express, again this part I am not covering over here, but basically either of these two options, let me select the first one. Here you can type, that means we have already created an Excel sheet or a spreadsheet over here. The same thing you can do over here as well, but because we have a list, so I am not selecting the first option. You have to select the second option using an existing list. So it will you will have to select say for example the name of the Excel file. The name of the Excel file is datasource.xlsx. So from here you can select datasource.xlsx. Now just try to observe this recipient list. The first row is the column heading name, address and city, and then the actual names and addresses start. So if you try to observe over here, first row of data contains column headers. So if the first row contains column headers, you have to put a tick over here. In our case, the recipient Excel sheet contains column headers, so by default this option is selected. We select this option. If there are multiple sheets over here, one Excel file can have multiple sheets, you can, those sheets will be listed over here and you can select one of them over here, but we have only one sheet, so we select that and give OK. Fine. So the first step is done. Once again I repeat, say for example you are here, you have to select the mailings option, select recipients, that means from where or to whom you want to send the mail. So you have to select the option using an existing list, and there you can select the datasource.xlsx. Ideally what you need to do is the Word and Excel files that you have created, you need to keep it in the same folder. That will make your task easier. It is not that it is necessary to have both the files in the same folder. The files can be at different locations, then also your task will be done. But here, to make our task easier, we are doing it in this way. Now here you want the name of the recipient. So now we start with the second step of the mail merge, that is edit recipient list. When I select edit recipient list, all the four names that were there in the Excel sheet over here, this is the Excel sheet or the spreadsheet, four names are there, all these names will come up over here. Say for example I want to send the invitation to only the first two friends, then I can select only the first two, but I want to send it to all, so I will send it to all. You can do sort, filter, number of things can be done in case this recipient list is long, but here the recipient list is a short list, so I need not worry about those steps. Fine, I have selected all the recipients, I have given OK. Now I want to add the name over here. I want to address the address of the first recipient, city of the first recipient. So how to do that? So I select this much, and the third step is insert merge field, where I have to select the name, say for example name. Now I have to select the second field, which is the address. And after the address, just for the formatting purpose, I put up a comma and the city. So here I put the city, and just for the formatting purpose, once again I put a full stop. Now try to observe over here, to and dear friend, that means the name is coming twice over here. So again over here you have to select the name. So the name of your friend will appear twice in the invitation. Fine. So just to recollect the steps, let me write it down. What we do, select the recipient list file dot xlsx, which you have already created. B, select the recipients. Of course this is optional. If you want all, then there is no problem, you can skip this step. C dot, what you have to do is we are inserting the merge field. So we write insert the merge fields at proper location in document. So these are the three steps that you need to follow, A, B and C, which I have listed over here. On doing this, almost the things are ready. Now how to check whether the things are done or not? So you can click on preview result. When I click on preview result, just try to observe, here it is record 1. So the first record in the Excel sheet is of Sachin Tendulkar. So Sachin Tendulkar and his address appears over here. As I click on the next record, if I check the Excel sheet or the spreadsheet, the second record is of Rahul Dravid. So that name will appear over here, and the address of that recipient will also appear. Then the third one and the fourth one. So this is previewing the result. But now what I want to send the invitation to 4 of my friends through a different document. So I remove the preview, and let me write down over here, step D, preview results, and step E. What I want to merge. Now so what I will do, yes, I want to print individual documents. I can do select either of the things. I can send email message, but that of course if we have selected from the Outlook, which we have not covered. So print documents. Again over here you have an option, in the sense, if you don't want to send the invitation to all, if you want to send invitation to only first few friends, then that is possible over here. I give OK. Once I give, sorry, this will directly go to the printer. I don't want on a printer, I want in a file. So I select the first option, edit individual document. Again the same step, I will select all records. So what will happen over here? You observe one more file letters one is created, where the first page is the invitation to the first invitee, the second page is the invitation to the second invitee, the third to the third friend, the fourth to the fourth friend. And then I can do file save as, I can save it as a doc file, I can save it as a PDF file and take a printout and either send it as a mail, that means a regular courier mail, or I can do an email as well. So this is the basic concept of a mail merge, where once again let us try to observe. We have two documents, one the letter or the content which you want to send to multiple friends or multiple recipients, and the second file that you have is that of the recipient. So you want to merge the data of recipient with the data of the content. The content is also known as the body content. So this is what you want to do. And now let us try to check how we can achieve the same thing as far as Python is concerned. Yes, in Python we are going to do it little bit in a different way, and we are going to use the different body content as well. I am going to teach you some of the things, but I am going to give you some homework also which you will have to do. So now for the moment let me close this Word file. I am giving save, okay, cancel, let me not save it, let me close this file as well, and let me close this file, I don't want to save, fine. Now using Python, what we are going to do, we are going to create two text files, one for the body or content, second for the names. Okay, instead of having Excel and Word file, we are going to have both in a text file. Why? Because we have already studied how to read and write data to a text file. Now if the names are in the CSV file, you can do it very easily. So let us try to check out Python. Yes, here I have the body.txt. Now it is just a short content. MVM College of Commerce Management and IT invites you for the farewell on 2nd May. Just let me make it capital. Please grace this occasion. Just a short description of two line, just a short content of two line. I want to send this invitation to whom? The names are there in the names.txt file, and here are the names to whom I want to send the invitation. So again what we are going to do is we are going to combine name one name from the text file over here with the body contents that are there over here. And what we are going to do is, yes, as output, let me write it down over here. Output will be n number of merge txt files and docx files. That is, first we'll try to do it in the text file, and then we'll create a Word document as well. And similarly, you can directly send the mail to the mail IDs as well, but that is a next step which we will learn little bit later on. So let us try to go to the Python IDLE and try to check the code that is already there. I have already created the mailmerge.py file just to save the time. First I am putting this in comments, and I put this also in comments. We will talk about this little bit later on. Now what we are doing is names is equal to open names.txt in read mode, and then I am opening the body file or the content file body.txt in read mode. We have already studied how to read and write data to a text file. You can revise those things little bit and you will be able to recollect the things. Now what we are doing, because let me go back to the body file. This has to be taken as a single variable or stored in a single variable, because this is the content of the mail of your invitation, and you want this content to be sent to different recipients or different friends of yours. Sorry, I opened the body file itself. Yes, you want to send that content to each of your friends separately. Yes, there is little bit of difference in the way in which I have written the content over here and in the previous example of Word and Excel, but that is fine. You can do those changes a little bit later on. So yes, we go to the Python code. I am just printing strb, so actually this step is not required. It is just for debugging purpose, whether it is reading the contents properly. Same way I can do something over here, like print strn. Why I am printing? It's just reading the names one by one. What I am doing over here for n in names basically is a pointer to the names.txt. Remember, using read we can read the entire contents, but if we want to read one line at a time, it can be done either using read line or making use of a loop. So here I have made use of a loop for n in names. So n will store the first line of data. That is why I am trying to check whether it is correct or not. Now I am taking one variable mail, where I am combining hello, then name, and then the content. So all these three things I am combining. Now this, if I try to check, can be changed little bit depending upon how you want. Say for example, here the body and contents are different. Body is different and contents is different. If we try to check it in the birthday file, let me just check it. Yes, birthday invitation. This is again the body or the content part, and here we have several of the things separated out: name, address, city. So if we want it in this way, then you need to make some changes over here. Where is the code? Let me go to the Python code. Yes, then you have to make some changes over here, and with those changes, basically in one variable we are storing one particular invitation. Again, this all these three print statements are for debugging purpose, to check whether whatever we are doing is being done correctly or not, that is, our code is correct or not. So print mail, and the entire mail, in the sense the merge document, we want to print. Now what we want to do is, if you remember in the previous example, we had created a separate invitation to each of the recipient. So I want to create a text file, and the name of the text file should be the name of the recipient, and inside it the name of the recipient and the content. So what I am doing, f is equal to open n dot strip. Basically what is n? N is the name from the names file. So it will fetch the name, and plus is a concatenation operator in Python, dot txt and in write mode. That is, we are opening a text file in write mode, and I am not giving the entire file name, but the file name will have the name of the recipient as it shows over here. F.write mail, that is, because the mail contains the entire invitation along with the name of the recipient, I am writing the mail, and then finally I am closing the file. That is, the file that I have opened for writing, that I am closing. And how many times this process will occur? For each name that is there in the names.txt file, this process is going to occur. So let us try to check out. Let me give F5, and if we try to observe, first the body appears, then the first name appears, then the mail. This is the actual content of the mail, the invitation, hello friend, and the invitation, the second name, third name, and the last name. So yes, on screen we are getting the things correctly, but now in the same folder where the two files are there, in the sense the Python file as well as the names and the body file, in the same folder multiple text files should be created. So let us try to check it out. As you can see over here, this is my folder, and yes, Rahul, Sachin, Sindhu, and Virat. Say if I try to open any of this, hello Sachin, say for example I want to put a comma after name, then what to do? So let us try to make some change over here. I had told you that you can make some changes over here. So I can put comma, in fact it will go to the next line. So because I can put it over here and you can get it. Right now we are not making changes to the file, but this is what you can do it over here. The thing is, what happens is, we just go to the next line. Here already we have a slash n, that means new line character is already there, so it will be taking it to the new line or the end of line character. Fine. Now let us try to learn something. We want the text file, instead of a text file, let me go back to the text file. Yes, this was the invitation. Instead of the text file, I want that this invitation should be stored in the doc file, because doc file is much better. And just try to observe over here, the name of the text file is the name of the recipient, and it will be for all the recipients. So the recipient, the file that is created is with the name of the recipient. So now we want to repeat that using the docx. But before we go further, I had put some comma over here. You have to apply little bit of logic, but you have to put a comma and you have to try and check whether the things are fine or not. So we want the output in a Word document. So definitely you will have to use some library, import docx. And remember, for that you have to install something at the command prompt using an administrator, pip install python-docx. This is the module or library that you need in order to perform this. So now I will remove the comments over here and we try to understand the last part. Yes, you have to write import docx. Now what we are doing, doc is equal to docx.document. This is something to opening the file for writing. Okay, it's just a pointer or a file handler you can think of. And first here the process is little bit reverse to writing the content to the text file. Doc.addParagraph. AddParagraph is the name of the method that you will be using to add something to the doc file or the docx file. And what you want mail as the paragraph. And then doc.save. Here when you are opening, you are creating the file with the same name. In case of Word, the process is reverse. First you store the things in a paragraph and then you save the file. Yes, saving the file, almost the method is the same that we were using in the above case. So with this, what is going to happen? Separate Word documents are going to be created with the names of the recipients. Just let us try to execute this. Yes, on the Python prompt it will show all the output one by one. But let us try to check over here whether the document is created or not. Yes, we have Sachin.docx, Sindhu.docx, Rahul, and one more name, Virat. So let us try to open one. So you have the things over here. Now what you have as homework, first you need to make changes so that comma is coming over here. Remember, it is not that easy because the end of line character is there, so you have to be careful little bit. In addition to it, what we have done over here is we have taken both files as text files. You can take first this file names as .csv file. You have already studied how you can read data from the CSV file. Now instead of writing a loop for reading from the text file, you have to have a loop for reading the data from a CSV file, and the other process is going to remain the same. That is the first homework that you have to do. The second homework that you have to do is, instead of the content or the body part of the mail that is being repeated, that you want to send to multiple of your friends or multiple recipients, in a text file you have to do little bit of research and use a Word file over here, just like we had done in our mail merge example that we had studied initially. So basically it is simple as far as mail merging in Python is concerned. you have to just open the two files, one file with the list of recipients, the another file with the body content, and then try to combine the two contents and write it to separate files. Yes, instead of writing it to separate files, you can also add the contents to a single file. That is also possible, like we had seen in Word. So both the things are possible. Now just let us try to revise the things what we have studied today. Yes, we have studied mail merge. First, we want to understand the concept properly, so that we have done using Word and Excel. Let me open the file once again. Yes, and take you through the steps once again. First, go to mailings. First step, select the recipients. Because we are using an existing file, you use existing file, and the name of the Excel file where the recipient list is there, only one sheet, so fine. The second step, yes, edit recipient list. If you want to add some or remove some, then you can do it. Basically, it is not a case of adding, it is case of removing some or arranging it in some order. The third step, you have to insert the merge field. Say for example, over here I can just insert name. Here I can insert, say for example, address, and I can put a comma over here, and here I can insert city and put a full stop over here. So this thing is clear. And of course, here you can have once again the merge field, that is name, and I can put a comma. The next step is to preview the results. Yes, the first record is coming. You go to the next record is coming. And finally, the last step is to edit individual documents. That is, you don't want to print them, but you want to store them in a new Word file. So I will give OK. So in one document, you have all the four invitations depending upon the number of recipients that you have. Based on it, our actual target is to learn how to do this in Python. That is, yes, using Python. Using Python, we have already studied how to read a text file. So yes, we are studying mail merge using two text files, one for the body or content, one for the names, and the output will be n number of text files as well as docx file depending upon the number of recipients. Remember, we want each file with the name of the recipient. So let us quickly go through this. Yes, you have to install one module, python.docx. remember that you have to go to the CMD, but open it as an administrator. Once you have installed this, then you are opening two text files. You are reading the first file. Just for debugging purpose, you are printing it. You are reading the names, printing the names. Here changes can be there depending upon how you want to make the output, and you have to learn how to get the comma over here. That is your homework. Yes, we are printing just to check whether the things are being printed properly or not. Then we are creating separate files, text files with the name of the recipient and doc files with the name of the recipient. The process for the text file and the doc file is little bit different. But again, your homework, here from a CSV file, here from a Word file. Okay. So with this, we end this session. Hope you have understood all the things, and make sure that you are trying it out practically. Unless and until you don't do the practicals, you are not going to understand. Thank you.